Friends, today we'll discuss the two transistor analogy model of the SCR, that is also called as the equivalent circuit for the silicon controlled rectifier. Now, once we know that SCR operation, we must know how the SCR operates, how the working of the SCR internally take place when the SCR starts conducting, means how the current circulation take place in the SCR during the operation of the SCR. So it is better to understand the SCR with the help of two transistor analogy model. So you can see here, SCR is nothing but it is a three junction, four layer, three terminal semiconductor device. So that is basically the SCR. Okay. So here you can see it is a gate terminal. So it is a three terminal, four layer, three junctions semiconductor device. But SCR is a unidirectional device. So what is the difference between the unidirectional device and the bidirectional device? The unidirectional device conducts in only one direction, means current will flow only from anode to cathode, and it will not allow the current to flow from cathode to anode. That is the meaning of unidirectional device. So here you can see that this one is called as the PNP transistor. So PNP transistor, SCR is divided into two parts in transistor wise. It is a combination of PNP device and the NPN device. So you can see here PNP, P1, N1, P2 is the three layers of the one transistor, and N1, P2, N2 is the another layer of another transistor, second transistor. So you can represent this model with the help of transistor like this. So you can see here, this transistor is represented like this, the symbolic representation like this, and transistor Q2 will be draw like this. So second transistor is called as the Q2 transistor, whereas first transistor is called as the Q1 transistor. So here you can see it is a PNP transistor, where Q2 is nothing but NPN transistor. So it is a NPN transistor. Means what? It is a combination or back-to-back connection of two transistors, that is PNP and NPN transistor. They are connected back-to-back. Back-to-back connection means what? The output of first transistor is acting as an input of the another transistor, and output of the first transistor is acting as an input of the second transistor. So means what? When the transistor starts conducting, the collector current of first transistor will act as a base current for the first transistor. So this is called as the IB1. So this is called as the IB2. The base current for transistor 2 is IB2, whereas base current for transistor Q1 is IB1. But what is the base current? In this case, it is nothing but the IC1. What is the IB2? IB2 is nothing but it is a combination of IG plus IC2. Means in short, IC2 will act as an IB2. So for this transistor Q2, you can have emitter current, which is called as a cathode current. This anode current is nothing but the emitter current for the first transistor. Okay, so these are the current notifications, the anode current, cathode current, gate current. These are the notations which I have explained here with the help of two transistor analogy of the SCR. Now let us see the operation of the SCR, how this SCR conducts in the two transistor equivalent model. So see here, initially we know that if you see the symbol of the SCR, the symbol of the SCR will be like this. Okay, so this is the gate terminal, this is the anode terminal, and this one is the cathode terminal. So when we supply the gate current to the SCR, we know that without application of the gate current, it is very difficult to turn on the SCR. But we can simplify the turn on process of the SCR by applying the little bit amount of gate current. So we can turn on the SCR by applying the high voltage to the in between anode to cathode, across the anode to cathode. But this turn on process requires very high amount of anode to cathode voltage. That's why we always suggest that please apply small amount of or little bit amount of gate current to turn on the SCR at earlier voltages. That is the importance of IG. So when we supply the IG to the transistor Q2, what will happen? A base current will flow. means the base current will start flowing. When the base current is flowing, depending upon that, what happened? The output current flows. Because we know that output of the transistor is nothing but the gain of the transistor Q2 multiplied by the input current. That is nothing but the IG initially. So this IG is nothing but the input current into the gain of the transistor is nothing but the output current. Now this output current becomes the base current for transistor Q1. Now here, depending upon the magnitude of the base current, what will happen? The collector current will flow. Now I will tell you how it will flow. Let us assume that the IG is of 1 milliampere. Means you have applied the gate current of 1 milliampere to the base of the transistor. So what will happen for this 1 milliampere? Let us say the gain of the transistor is 100. So what will happen? Gain is nothing, output is nothing but gain times input. Means what? Gain is nothing but 100 and into input is 1 milliampere. So this is 1. So what is the output? Output is 100. So output is 100 milliampere. By supplying the 1 milliampere of gate current, you are getting output current, which is the magnitude of IC2. So this IC2 becomes 100 milliampere. And this 100 milliampere is now acting as a base current for the transistor Q1. Means what? Now see, how much is the output input current to the transistor? Is 100 milliampere. Now this 100 milliampere multiplied by again the gain of this transistor Q1 is like, let us say 100. Means output of this transistor Q1 is nothing but again gain multiplied by input. So this gain is 100 multiplied by input is again 100, because input is 100 milliampere. So this 100 and this 100 gain becomes 100 into 100. How much it is? 10,000. So this much is the output current, which is nothing but the collector current for the transistor Q1. Okay. Now this much amount of current will circulate to the base of the transistor Q2. So what happened? The action is so cumulative, so fast, that it will set up the current inside the device and it will comes into the conduction. And because of that, it is possible for anyone to supply the gate current for making the device to be conduct at earlier voltages. Okay, so that is the meaning of two transistor equivalent model. This is very important to study, because initially the two transistor model exist in the SCR, and once that SCR starts conducting, these two transistor model will not exist and only the current will start flowing from anode to cathode, because gate loses the control. Why the gate loses the control? Now you can see how much gate current we have supplied is the 1 milliampere, and how much collector IC2 is we are getting is 10,000 milliampere. So do you think that really 1 milliampere matters in front of 10,000 milliampere? Definitely not. Means if you remove this IG at all from this circuitry, still the current will flow into the circuit. So means what? That is the significance of current which set up earlier in the device. And because of that, the large current starts flowing from anode to cathode. So in this way, the current flows from anode to the transistor, to this circuit, to this circuit, to the cathode. And in this way, the current circulates. Now this current is forward current through up the SCR. Means what? The current flowing from this point to this point. So current always flows from this point to this point. It never flows in reverse direction. So that's why it is called as the unidirectional device. Now how this current set up? We know that IC1 is nothing but alpha 1. Alpha is the gain of the transistor, that transistor. IE1 is the current of that transistor, emitter current of the transistor, plus the leakage current of the first transistor. So that's why it is represented. IC1 is the leakage current for the first transistor. And similarly, output current of the second transistor is IC2. This IC2 is nothing but gain of the transistor Q2, that is alpha 2, IE2 plus ICO2, that is again it is a leakage current. So you can see this from this equation, we can find out the anode current, which is nothing but alpha 2 into IG is the gate current plus ICO1 plus ICO2 divided by 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2. So this is the anode current equation which is exist when the gate current you have supplied. Okay, so when you not supplied the gate current, at that time this fact, when the gate current is not supplied, at that time this part is not there. So we can rewrite this equation with the help of anode current is equal to ICO1 plus ICO2 divided by 1 minus alpha 1 plus alpha 2. So in this way you can say that the anode current, how much is the anode current setup, that you can find out from this equation. So in examination, in any examination, you take the gate examination, IAS examination, or your normal regular university examination, you will find that there is a numerical based on this. They are asking this is the leakage current, this is the value of gain, and what is the magnitude of IG. You will have to find out the magnitude of IG or magnitude of anode current. From this equation you can find out. Okay, so in this way you can study the anode current equation from this two transistor equivalent model of the SCR. So I hope today you enjoy this class, you understand how the SCR conducts in forward direction, and depending upon that how the anode current will be set up in the SCR depending upon that. Thank you. Please do like, share and comment to my YouTube channel, which is Professor Jitendra Zavade, Online Learning Solution. Thank you.